Alrighty, welcome to a modern video here on channelfireball.com. Today we'll be synthesizing. Simulacrum Synthesizer is the name of the game. It's a 3-mana artifact that ETBs and scries to. But whenever another artifact with mana value 3 or greater enters the battlefield into your control, you get a construct that's as big as the number of artifacts you control. The way to break this card, as many have found out, is cards like Frogmite, Thought Monitor, and Sojourner's Companion, which are all affinity cards, trigger the synthesizer, but also obviously cost you 0 to 1 mana depending on kind of the situation. So the deck's just trying to turbo that out with 4 Moonsnare Prototype, 4 Springleaf Drum, full 8 with 8 0 mana creatures to just maximize the turn 2 synthesizer plus Frogmite. And once you do turn 2 synthesizer plus Frogmite, if you can get to 4 artifacts there, you end up with a Construct, a Synthesizer, a Frogmite, whatever else you had before. Next turn, you're attacking for a ton. Urza's Saga is, of course, great here. Getting Lava Spur Boots, another new card, as well as Relic, Needle, Shadow Spear. And it's got a couple Metallic Rebukes for interaction, a bunch of artifact lands, and a sideboard mostly of artifacts because you do want those to kind of work with the rest of your deck. We're in a modern league now. Let's get to round one. All right. I am on the draw here, and so I'm going to go turn 1, Razortide Bridge, turn 2, I could go Saga into Synthesizer on 3, could cycle Sojourner's Companion. I actually think I'm just going to mulligan this hand. Yep, this is a much better hand. I'm going to keep this, and I don't think I need the second Ornithopter here, because now I've got turn 1, Spire of Industry, Ornithopter, Moonsnare Prototype, and I'm playing against Amulet. Well, I'm glad I mulled because this hand is quite a bit faster. Could use some Frogmites, but let's go Spire into Ornithopter, which gives me the blue off Spire for the Moonsnare Prototype, and pass the turn. Might still be too slow on the draw against Amulet, given kind of how that deck functions. Oh, they went Baseju? That's interesting. Okay, so that they probably have like another Baseju if I had to guess, but I guess we'll find out. Synthesizer. Oh wait, this needs to hold on, get blue. Springleaf Drum's a lot better than Moonsnare Prototype for our purposes. All right, Simulacrum Synthesizer. Scry 2, they're going to kill it, I think. They don't actually need to kill it right now, though I guess it kind of helps with against Frogmite. Oh, they should definitely let me scry first as well, because they're going to let me besage you and then scry? Oh, that's wild. All right, well, yeah, get my island, and then scry 2. I'm looking for Frogmite, though Thought Monitor actually might be pretty good. So let's say next turn I'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 artifacts. Oh, I will be a little short on Thought Monitor, unfortunately. I can't play. Let's see. 1, because Spire doesn't count. 1, 2, 3, 4 artifacts. I guess I'm still going to put them both on top and I'll just draw Urza's Saga first. No reason to play this Ornithopter, I don't think. And then next turn I can go Urza's Saga, Nettle, or Simulacrum Synthesizer, and then kind of combo off from there. If I had one more mana, then we could really get something going here, because I would go Synthesizer into Thought Monitor. Oh, no plays again. Okay, Urza's Saga, Simulacrum Synthesizer. And I definitely want Thought Monitor. I don't want Tanglepool Bridge. All right. And pass the turn. Yeah. Just chill. They didn't do anything. I'm hoping they don't draw a Bounce Land. If I can get one more turn of no Bounce Land, I feel like I can get there. All right. So they kept an Amulet hand with no Bounce Land, apparently. So now let's get to casting the Thought Monitor for 1 mana. So right now it costs 2 mana. So let's go Nettle Cyst first. And I guess I'm not going to use Urza's Saga this turn. Yeah, that's fine. Nettle Cyst, make something giant, make something giant. Thought Monitor, Do the same. I mean, this deck just goes crazy. And I could play Springleaf Drum and Memnite. I guess I'll play the Springleaf Drum because I don't really see a reason not to. And pass the turn. I was kind of hoping to draw a land so that I could equip the Nettle Cyst, but I mean, this is like 1,000 damage next turn anyway. All right, well, this deck goes pretty hard when it goes. All right, so Damping Spheres can help make the Sagas less good, and I want another Metallic Rebuke. I don't think I want Hibernation. Grafdigger's Cage is not really where we're at. And here, Relic. Needle can stop the One Ring to a degree, and it can name random lands, but it's kind of hard to know what they've got. I think I just take out some of the ones, Relic and Lavas and Shadow Spear. I'll keep the Lavaspur boots, I suppose. And given kind of what we're doing here, I'll just kind of trim on some of the other stuff. All right, see how this goes. All right, on the draw, yeah, the Springleaf Drum definitely makes this a keeper. I can actually lead on Saga. Turn one, Urza Saga, Springleaf Drum, Memnite, cast Moonsnare Prototype, and then can kind of go from there. All right, so no amulet. They're going to get an amulet soon. Lead on Saga, Springleaf Drum, Memnite, Moonsnare Prototype, I think is going to be the one I want to cast. I don't think I want to cast Needle here, and I don't think, I think next turn, oh wow, they're really going for it here. Okay, oh, Frogmite I think was actually really good, because now I can go land, Frog for zero, and I want to be able to use Saga. Let's see. So if I go Thought Monitor off of the Springleaf Drum, then I can still use Saga, but then I can't play Needle, and I want to Needle Mycosynth Gardens. So I think I'm just going to do that. Because if I Needle Mycosynth Gardens, they can't turn it into the amulet that they're going to go search up. So, and this taps an artifact, this taps a creature, so I can attack. Springleaf Drum Prototype, yeah. All right, and I can get the Thought Monitor out next turn. I think it's worth waiting a turn on that. So I guess the Frogmite didn't actually do that much. All right, now they get to tap this for a colorless. They get to get their amulet. I might have to use my mana on Metallic Rebuke instead of making a Saga token. I just kind of hope not. Okay, they get to untap it. And see what they bounce. They bounce the Gardens, and they're going to play the One Ring. Yeah, I'm going to Metallic Rebuke it as much as I am loath to do that. I mean, yeah, I can't make a Saga token. Oop, oh, there we go. All right, I'll just have to make a Saga token on my turn. I mean, the One Ring is just going to be way too much action for that to be the case. All right, draw. Make a Saga token. And then go get, I kind of want to just get Lavaspur Boots. My Saga token's pretty big. But I think I am going to still play Thought Monitor. Tapping the Memnite. Because I would like to draw just any land off this. Untapped land would have been better, but let's attack. And then next turn, the thing that's kind of nice though is I have Moonsnare Prototype, and the channel on that is actually some nice extra interaction. Oh, also I just have Lethal next turn anyway, if they don't put something out, because right now, I mean, I have 15 right now on the board. Boots, if I equip, makes it 16. Thought Monitor makes it 17 from the construct, but actually even two more from the Thought Monitor thanks to the boots. Though, obviously, if I want to use the Moonsnare Prototype, that costs 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, I don't even have the 5th mana for that yet. But a land would activate that. So we'll see what they come up with. Colony Garden. Yeah, that does provide a blocker. Let's see. So I'm not going to have lethal then through the Colony Garden token, but I'm going to get to play another Thought Monitor here. If I drew a land, I would just leave the mana up for Moonsnare Prototype, though Damping Sphere I think is actually going to be kind of nice too. Because now I can play Damping Sphere, turns off their Simic Growth Chamber. Okay. I'll equip Lava Spur Boots to the Thought Monitor nonetheless. And then they can use their Damping Sphere. Oh, I guess, did I actually want to play the Moonsnare Prototype? Well, I guess it's kind of relevant because I'm going to get two now. Now, actually, pretty much sure I don't want to play Moonsnare. And because I just can use them next turn. All right, they're going to block the construct, take a million damage, and it's going to be pretty hard for them to go off from where they started, though it's possible. Second amulet into bounce land, into prime time. I mean, they'd have to have a lot of those things that they didn't seem to have the last couple turns, but, you know, I guess they don't. All right, well, we can beat amulet with mediocre draws. Let's get to round two. All right, so this hand is got the speed. It's missing a synthesizer. I'm not sure yet, but I think you can keep a hand that has all the building blocks and is missing synthesizer or Vault Monitor. Urza Saga would also be a fine draw, just like any of those cards. It's possible that I should just mulligan this hand because it's, you know, got three lands and two mana sources, but I really do think that having the ability to have turn two synthesizer is pretty good. Well, I actually don't hate that I kept this hand because Frogmite against Raghavan is kind of nice. Oh. Yeah. So let's go Citadel, Springleaf Drum. And then I can cast Moonsnare Prototype. Then I can cast Frogmite. And this at least blocks Raghavan, though, of course, if they bolt the frog, they're able to get around that. So this is a five color zoo with the ugliest lands in the universe. Yeah, I guess they're not. They just look really weird to me. Anyways, I need to draw an artifact. So that'll let me cast Nettle Cyst here. Sojourner's Companion is not going to do too much for them. Any untapped artifact will cast Nettle Cyst. The tap lands have a bit of a drawback. Oh, well, there goes my Nettle Cyst. Yeah, I mean, I think mulling against a Thoughtseize Unholy Heat start wouldn't have worked out great either. So, well, there's the synthesizer, which I can't quite cast this turn. So I guess I'll have to pass and let them Raghavan me again. I don't love it, but I guess that's where we're at. Yeah, I will pass the turn. Here's where Memnite would have been a little bit more useful. The good thing is if I draw a Frogmite, we are really doing it. Because if I draw a Frogmite, I then get to go Synthesizer plus immediately Frogmite. Actually, if I draw any of my 7 drops, it also works. Well, sorry, if I draw a Sojourner, if it doesn't work to draw Thought Monitor. I don't have quite enough for that. Oh, actually, no, Thought Monitor still works because of the Springleaf Drum. All right, you know, I just need to draw a big artifact here. They hit an Urza's Saga. Okay, that's okay. If they don't have another Thoughtseize here, then I feel like I could be in decent shape. I don't really care if they play like a Nishoba Brawler or Tarmogoyf or whatever. Those are just not that big of a threat. No, don't Thoughtseize me. Killing my Ornithopter would also be nice. Okay. They thought season, of course, I just drew the best card that turn. And then now Needle is not going to do it. Good enough for me, I guess. Oh, they were going to hit a Frogmite, though. All right. I guess I just want a couple Dismembers. I don't even really want Metallic Rebukes against them. And yeah, other than that, I'm just going to have to... Thoughtseize is not that effective against my deck, you know, if I have a faster draw, but given the way that worked out, yeah. Do I want the needle? I think. And Dotsie's Orvar's not very good against that. I mean, needle is kind of medium. Maybe I want actually one metallic rebuke over needle. I like relic against Tarmogoyf though. All right, I would like to play first here. I don't mind this hand. I think this hand's okay because I can go turn one Springleaf Drum. Turn two, I can play Moonsnare Prototype or another Springleaf Drum, and then I can have Frogmite up soon. If I draw land, I can cycle for Sojourner's Companion. I think this hand, I mean, maybe this hand's a little bit sketchy, but I hate mulling against Thoughtseize decks. It just is so bad. Okay, so a tapped artifact land would actually be great here. Getting Thoughtseized wouldn't be that bad. Another Moonsnare Prototype. So now I'm going to cast this. Hold on. Cast this for blue. And then cast Springleaf Drum. Tapping that. And then now, really did need to draw land there to have like a more explosive turn, but I still get to go Frog into Companion pretty soon here and have Metallic Rebuke up soon after that, though obviously not right away. Huh, they didn't crack Fetch end of turn. So they gave up getting a Triome or Surveil land. Okay, and they played at Dragon's Reach. Who keeps this one-landers? Let's tap the Springleaf Drum for a colorless. Oh, wait, no, hold on. That's not what I want to do. Tap this for blue. Cast Moonsnare Prototype. Cast Frogmite. And then I can artifact land cycle. Is that better? Yeah, that's probably better. Well, no, I can just cast this, actually. Let's just do that. Boom. All right. And then I have a 4/4. I have a 2/2. And then next turn, I can maybe play a Nettle Cyst. They kept their one land. They cycled their Street Wraith. The battle of the one landers, though, my one lander's working out a little bit better. And then, is there any way to keep. There's no way to keep Metallic Rebuke up, I don't think. So I'm just going to play Nettle Cyst like that. They have three card types, so I'm not attacking with Frogmite then. That seems foolish. Underworld Breach. They have all these alternate cards. They like their bling. I mean, now they got to be dead here. All right, going to game three. Underworld Breach, does that make me want... It doesn't really make me want Spell Pierce or anything like that. I've got one Rebuke. That actually seems fine. And then I'll put in a Gemstone Caverns over one of these artifact lands. I guess Razortide Bridge, sure. All right. Let's get in there. All right. So here, once again on the draw, I actually think this hand is okay. So we've had a wide range of hands. So the first hand was, you know, game one was like a bunch of mana sources, but no payoffs. Second hand was a one-lander with tons of, like, Springleaf Drums. And then this is a kind of slow hand that really wants to draw a zero. But if I do, then I think this hand gets pretty good. And this hand's quite good against Thoughtseize. All right, so let's play the tap land first. I don't really want to play turn one Urza's Saga when I don't have any zero-mana creatures. Because if I had a turn one, an Ornithopter or something like that, or Memnite, I could go turn one Springleaf Drum. Turn one Saga, Springleaf Drum, turn two Island, use it to make the Construct token, but we aren't doing that right here. Untapped Steam Vents, okay. They're getting their Death Shadow going here, I guess. Yeah, this might be a little slow. I mean, this hand was really hoping to draw a zero on the draw here. Oh, is this Pick Your Poison? Ay, okay. Yeah, that's pretty strong. All right. This gives me another chance to draw a zero, though. No. I'm just going to go Darksteel Citadel, Springleaf Drum. I just don't... Oh, am I getting Stubborn Denial? Okay. I just don't really want to play Saga when I don't have a follow-up. Well, they're kind of controlling the game here. If they don't have a threat and I can play Saga, that could be pretty good. Tarmogoyf obviously is a bit of a threat here. Oh, it's less of a threat now, because now I'm going to play Relic. And if they don't have another Stubborn Denial here, then I'll feel pretty good about the situation. Because now what I'm probably going to do is tap Relic. Oh, I was going to tap it to exile artifact. Oh, no, I guess I have two artifacts. So if I exile things now, they can make it a 2. Yeah, I'm going to do it now because I'm going to tap out next turn. So I'm just going to fire off the Relic. Oh, Dismember's nice. Okay. They look at my top card. They can even crack Verdant. They have a 2-3 Goyf. Not too scary. I'm really hoping they don't play another thing this turn. I would like to make a Saga token this turn, if I can. All right. No plays. All right. They get to draw, and they see... Oh, the Metallic Rebuke, the one card in my deck that matters. All right, all right. Land. I think I'm just going to make a Saga token. Oh, should I actually have played Urza Saga? I just kind of defaulted to playing Island. I should have played Urza Saga. It does keep up Metallic Rebuke, though. The reason I didn't want to play Simulacrum Synthesizer there is if I play Synthesizer and they like Stubborn Denial, it's just such a disaster. Whereas making the constructs is pretty good value. So let's make a construct. It's actually not that bad to not have played the thing. Bowmasters? Okay, because of Stubborn Denial. Sure, they're going to Bowmasters me now. I guess my Thought Monitors are less good. All right, draw. Just make another construct here. I think. And bolt one of my things. Okay. Kind of want Springleaf Drum. I don't really care about Lava Spur Boots. I can get Shadow Spear with the next Saga. Land. And I think I just pass. No, I guess there was no reason not to play Frogmite for one mana. And I'm actually going to dismember the Tarmogoyf now. While I still can. Because, oh, it's 5-6 because there's a creature now. Oof, they gave me a hard deck for a second because the classic bolting the Goyf and having it survive. But I looked, there's already instant in the graveyard, so it seemed fine to me. What is this? Nope. I mean, I guess it could be K-Command. Kill the Construct and the Frogmite. Yeah. Okay. But they're only hitting for 2. I know I have another Saga ready to start going. All right. Here's where it would be pretty nice to just draw one of my artifact lands or something. Oh, Memnite's actually kind of nice too. Let's see. Definitely cast the Memnite. And I can artifact land cycle, get a Darksteel Citadel, play Citadel, and then I can make a token with the Urza Saga still, and the token be a 5-5. All right, that feels pretty good. These synthesizers aren't doing that much, but you know what? They don't need to. I'm getting there on Urza Sagas alone. Dragon's Rage Channeler, sure. And another Tarmogoyf. All right. And a land. They have no cards in hand? Okay. All right. I like where we're at. They can't attack here. And if I can draw another Frogmite or something, we could do something. Ooh. Okay. So I do have to remember they have Orcish Bowmasters in play. Gonna make another token. Gonna get Shadow Spear. Then I'm gonna equip Shadow Spear to the big construct. Tap the Memnite. And send for 8 here. I'm happy to trade for Tarmogoyf. They're just gonna take it. Alright. Well, in that case, I think we're doing just fine here. Shadow Spear plus Constructs. They need to draw K-Command like right now. And they probably can't have that many. All right. 2-0. Nice start. All right, time for round three. I would like to play first. And so the only problem with this hand is Springleaf Drum and Moonsnare Prototype are not the same, because here I can go Saga, Shadow Spear, Ornithopter. Just if I had a Springleaf Drum or a blue, I'd be all over this hand. I think that hand is missing too much. I mean, I guess I have to keep this hand. Just no blue mana is unfortunate. Well, what I'll probably do is go keep it, put back Metallic Rebuke, and then go Darksteel Citadel Relic, Urza's Saga, and crack the Relic. Something along those lines. And then I can spend a couple turns making Saga tokens and hope to draw... Well, I could draw blue, or I could just get Springleaf Drum again with the Urza Saga trigger. That would also work. All right. Darksteel Citadel Relic. Put a mold to 5 here. All right. Also, whenever you have Relic in your opening hand, you could be playing against, like, Dredge or something that Relic hoses them, though it does not appear that that's what's the case here. Nettle Cyst. I'm actually going to exile the Relic. I've got a lot of one-drops in my deck. Metallic Rebuke has been so unbelievably bad so far. It's wild. I guess if I'm playing against a Tarmogoyf deck, then this could be bad, but it looks like I'm playing against the Yawgmoth is most likely here. The Underground Mortuary Verdant Catacombs combo. Pick Your Poison, definitely a card to be aware of. That card is very strong against this deck, especially when you lead on like tapped artifact land or something along those lines. Next turn, I'll just make a Saga token. And then they're going to play their Wall of Roots, yeah. Yawgmoth into Young Wolf, too. Wow, nice. Draw. All right, pass the turn. I think a Saga token's better than Nettle Cyst. It's like casting a Nettle Cyst, except I just don't have the Nettle Cyst in my hand, so that seems better. Drawing a land would be nice. Even just Island would be fine. Spire of Industry. Something along those lines. And here, Grist. Hungertide. Yeah, Grist is a good one. Make a token. Mill a Yawgmoth. Can't even attack. Alright, make a token. I'm going to be forced to get Springleaf Drum if I don't draw. Let's see. Do I make a token? I think I do. I think that's better than just playing one of the threes, because I can kind of do it all next turn here. 5/5. I'm just going to attack the Grist now, because I'm just going to chump it either way. Okay. Yeah, chumps. They go Memnite and Moonsnare Prototype. Tapping the Memnite and pass the turn. And then next turn, if I draw blue, I can cast Simulacrum Synthesizer and then cast Thought Monitor. If I draw no land, I could just cast Thought Monitor first and see what that leads to. Uh-oh. They drew a land. They missed their land drop last turn. This is turn 4. So could easily have a Yawgmoth in hand, or they could Cord for a Yawgmoth. I mean, the constructs are pretty big. They do get to Grist one of them if that's what they want to do. No, they're just making a creature. No, there's a Cord and a Yawgmoth in the graveyard now. But seems pretty likely they have a Yawgmoth or Cord in hand, especially if they're plussing Grist here. So I feel like I'm going to be a turn slow here. My draw was on the slow side, so we'll see, though. Orcish Bowmasters, okay. Getting punished for drawing Memnite instead of Ornithopter here. Yeah, this is looking bad, because I assume they're courting now. Oh, Haywire Mite? Haywire Mite, they have one card in hand? All right. They're going to kill my Springleaf Drum with Haywire Mite at the very least. They can do that. No, they're courting. Yeah. This looks pretty much over. So now they can make their young wolf non-undying. They can start shrinking my constructs here. They can draw like a million cards. Yeah, I'm pretty dead here. Like, especially with a Haywire Mind active too, it's just not happening. All right, so here I've got Cursed Totems and Dismembers. Two Cursed Totem, two Dismember at the moment. Just not a big Metallic Rebuke fan in general. And Needle's good. Relic isn't really that good against Yawgmoth. And do I want Lava Spur Boots? I think I kind of like just having that card regardless. I might just take out a Nettle Cyst against their artifact removal. It's my most expensive artifact, so I don't like that. All right, I would in fact like to play first. Yeah, this is a lot more like it. So I do still fear Pick Your Poison, but that's just, I think one of the downsides of playing an artifact deck in this day and age is that card is just really good. They lead on that, I'm going to be pretty unhappy. And they are. Well, at least my Saga didn't get killed. Draw. Now I have to go Saga into Springleaf Drum. And my plan is to go, hopefully draw zero so I can play a Frogmite. I don't have the time to, like, I could have played Spire of Industry, but I think getting Saga going is good enough. If I draw any of the zeros, then it's going to be really good. If not, things get a little dicier, not going to lie, but I think that I've got some chances here. Oh, Underground Mortuary. Just surveilling now, huh? Just firing it off. If they have a second Pick Your Poison, it's just going to be a disaster for me. Gisa the Hellraiser. Oh, nice. Yawgmoth commits a crime. Very cunning. Very cunning. All right. Any zero drops? Oh, Force of pitching Pick Your Poison. Sure. All right. I guess I'll play Spire of Industry here. Well, I mean, look, it's not great if they've drawn a Force of Vigor and two Pick Your Poisons in the first three turns, but, you know, it's okay. They'll have Grist. Now they'll have Grist into... Oh, Honest Rutstein getting back Gisa. Sure. That's fine, I guess. And Darksteel Citadel. I'm going to cycle the Sojourner's Companion now. And then next turn I can go Darksteel Citadel, Shadow Spear, Frogmite. And I'm in a lot of trouble, I will say. But, I mean, I think that's actually a pretty reasonable demonstration of what the drawback is of playing a deck based on artifacts, is they get to, decks like the one we're playing against get to play a lot of artifact removal. Oh, Moonsnare Prototype is interesting. Let's see. If I go Shadow Spear, Frogmite costs one. I mean, there's no way to cast the... Thought Monitor this turn anyway, so might as well just play the two frogs, and then I can even equip a Frogmite with a Shadow Spear. All right. Next turn, I do get to cast this Thought Monitor, which is kind of nice. Maybe I can get something going with that. Not feeling like that's really going to work, but you never know. One mana Wallaroots. How busted. A two mana Grist. Okay, make a token. That's not committing a crime. Oh. All right, I guess I'll double block Gisa. I don't expect this to go well, but... What am I going to do? Besiege you. Yeah. All right, well, hopefully I get to get some goods off this thought monitor. If I draw Simulacrum Synthesizer right now, we could be doing something. All right, thought monitor. So let's play the Ornithopter to make it cheaper. Mm-hmm. String together some thought monitors. Oh, cursed totem. All right. A little late on that, I'm afraid. Because, well, not even late on that. Their draw is actually pretty good against that. They don't have, like, they have Grist triggering Gisa now, killing the thought monitor. Yeah, that's kind of cool. They're cooking here. I got to admit. I guess I'm just dead here. I mean, I could chump, but I don't think I have any comebacks. And 2-1 here. Let's battle one more round. All right, I'm on the play here. I haven't had, playing against a companion. I haven't had a lot of early synthesizers, I'm afraid. I guess I keep this hand. I'm going to go Darksteel Citadel. Open on double ley line. Look at you. Fancy. I guess I'll play the Memnite, sure. I don't really think there's a big reason to play the Ornithopter. The Memnite might attack for one. I don't really care too much if they kill it here. Okay, so Vitrium, go. All right, Springleaf Drum, still be a pretty good draw. I guess because of Roggavon, maybe I shouldn't attack there. If they're playing like Five Color Zoo. But if their play is Dashing Roggavon, that's also kind of weak. All right, Territorial Kavu. Well, I'm going to get to make some Saga tokens now. Okay, and I'm going to play my Ornithopters and pass the turn. And then next turn I can get Springleaf Drum. And if I draw a blue source, we might be getting into the synthesizer into Thought Monitor territory. So I could make a Saga token and block. That seems extremely greedy, so I will not be doing that. Yeah, I'll take 5. Tribal Flames worries me, but if I make a Saga token and block and they have a Lightning Bolt, it's just like I lose my whole board. And if I just wait, the Saga tokens get pretty big. Oh, we're going to have a showdown here. Okay. Make a token. Draw a blue source. Oh, another Saga. I could make a token. But then I'm giving up making a token with that Saga, so it doesn't really change much, I don't think. And I do think I want Springleaf Drum, given my hand. And play another Saga. Create a token. And then I can play the Thought Monitor for 1 mana, which is what I'm going to do. Tap an Ornithopter. And let's, if I draw a cheap thing, that'd be kind of nice. Not so much. Okay. Pass the turn, I think. I think that given that I can get a Shadow Spear next turn, I just want to kind of hold the line here. And yeah, not lose to a bunch of Leyline Bindings, though. If they have another one here, it's pretty bad for me. We have 2 cards in hand. I think the way things currently stand, if they attack, I'll put a Construct on a Kavu. Am I supposed to put a Construct and a Thought Monitor on a Kavu by any chance? Oh, Jewel Dog, another Leyline Binding. Okay. I mean, they're just going off here. I guess I probably am supposed to block one of them so I don't die to one Tribal Flames. We'll see what they discard. They're exiling a Saga? Huh. They like their hand. They don't want to rummage. I don't like that. All right. Chump, go to 10. If they Tribal Flames me twice, then I guess I lose. We'll see what they've got. No plays. Okay. I'm going to put these on the stack. I am going to make a construct, I think. Yeah, that seems fine. Mm-hmm. I'm going to get Shadow Spear. Well, I guess... Do I need Shadow Spear right now? What's the advantage of doing it right now? Probably not equipping this turn. So, I don't think Relic helps me much. Because right now I've got... I could equip Shadow Spear. I guess I'll just get Shadow Spear anyway. Because I don't really want to get another... Springleaf Drum. They didn't have... You know what? They didn't have the... double Tribal Flames already, so I think I'm just going to play these and then ship the turn. I don't really think attacking does much for me. And... Another Leyline Binding? Okay. I might have to go to five here. Next turn. I'm taking... Well, we'll see what they discard, but if they don't discard... I mean, if their hand was all with all Leyline Bindings and Territorial Kavus, I totally understand discarding Tribal Flames here. They're exiling my graveyard. It really doesn't matter. Yeah. I just feel like they have a Tribal Flames here. I'll just block. Stay at 10. Wild Nakadu? Oh, no. Neshoba Brawler. Okay. So let's draw. Frogmite or something would be kind of nice. All right, let's make another Saga token. And I think I just get an Ornithopter here. Play Darksteel Citadel. Equip Shadow Spear on the construct. And pass the turn. And then, all right, they have to have another Leyline Binding. Number four, literal number four, or like double Tribal Flames, because Tribal Flames itself will not do it, because I'm not taking any damage this turn. Okay. Now they get to do some looting. Yeah. And I think I will probably block Ornithopter on one of them. Let's see. They looted a land. So I kind of think they have a Tribal Flames in hand. I'll block there. Block the other Kavu. I take -5 damage. And then now they can Tribal Flames the... Construct token, I guess. A Wild Nacodle. But I get to play Nettle Cyst next turn. Oh, they didn't even have it. After all that. Yeah, let's go Nettle Cyst. And, I mean, now we're just going to equip Nettle Cyst onto the construct here. Tap the Germ, because it's going away. And... Send. I mean, they didn't have a removal spell for it before. So, yep, bolt that. take 17. They go to 1. I go to 32. I would say we battled against a lot of stuff. This shows the resilience of this deck. Pretty effectively. All right. So it turns out when they discarded the Tribal Flames, they just had a bunch of Leyline Bindings and Kavus in hand, so that was just their worst card. So I did chump one or two times more than I needed to, but it felt like I was winning enough that I was okay doing that. Yeah, I'll take 13, go to 19. The time for chumping is over. And there goes Tribal Flames on themselves. All right. Oof. That was a nice game. Yeah, dismember. Hibernation is kind of nice. It can bounce all green permanents. So if they have ley line, it's all their creatures plus the ley lines. Gemstone Caverns on Zdraw. Oh, actually, I should swap out these artifact lands for blue-black artifact lands. It doesn't really matter which ones they are unless they're as long as they're blue. And I actually do like taking out some Nettle Cysts just because... Oh, and Rebukes. Just because we're playing against decks that will bring in a bunch of artifact removal, and that's your artifact that's most vulnerable to removal besides maybe the Synthesizer. But that you can get value out of right away. On the draw here... Oh yeah, this is a nice little hand. If they lead on Scion Leyline, then yeah, these dismembers aren't going to do that much, but I get to go turn one Saga. Turn one Raghavan? Well, maybe I won't go... Actually, I can go turn one Saga. I can go Saga, Ringleaf Drum, Ornithopter, dismember the Raghavan. No reason to play into Stubborn Denial or Spell Pierce or anything like that. And then turn two, I can make a Saga token. Unless they kill my Ornithopter. Oh, Raghavan plus tap land? Oh no, just no land? I can't say I mind that. And then I can cast the Moonsnare prototype and then pass and make a Saga token that's a 5/5 already on turn two. When this deck has its good draws, it's got its good draws. They can attack with Raghavan and get a Raghavan hit in here if they have a Leyline Binding. Well, no, they can't. Well, they can cast Leyline Binding. It would just be a little awkward for them. Yeah, I'm okay with that, I guess. They get to... They're going to kill this thing. I assume with Leyline Binding, getting like white-green or... Something along those lines. They get a Raghavan hit, and then next turn I get to cast Sojourner's Companion as well as making another token. Okay. Hopefully they don't hit anything too good, but there's not that much they can hit off Raghavan that they can cast. No, they hit a Odawara, so can't do anything. They have three cards in hand. Okay, let's create a Saga token. Let's get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, let's get Lavaspur Boots. We are getting in there. We'll cast the Sojourner's Companion and then put Boots on the Construct and then smash for 8. And they can't, and it is Ward 1 is also pretty relevant. If they really want to get the Sojourner's Companion out of the way, they can, but that is not going to do it. And we're finishing this video off with a 3-1 in the league. Pretty good. You know what? I think this deck's got some legs to it. Let's take a look at the deck list. Certainly the artifact lands, I think, should be switched to reflect dismembers. I added the dismembers after looking at a couple lists. I just think dismembers a great card. I just like cheap cards. I don't really want this many counters, I don't think. Like Metallic Rebuke, number 3, Spell Pierce is the 4th. I do like Cursed Totems and Damping Spheres. I like Orvars. I basically like cheap or free answers that are really punishing against the decks they're good in, plus dismember, which is kind of like a catch-all. So I would make a few adjustments there. I like the main deck a lot. I think that there might be one too many tapped lands. 6 tap lands is kind of a lot for this deck, but I really like the core of Urza. This is an Urza Saga deck more than anything else. 8 of the one drop things plus 8 of the zeros plus sagas is a good start. The synthesizer I think is good, but I don't think that's actually the driving force behind the deck. I think it really is Urza Saga, though this gave it a pretty strong new toy to play with. So I do enjoy this deck. I'll be writing a deck guide for it as well. I think I'm going to play a little more and test out a few configurations, but this deck's been a lot of fun, and I look forward to playing with it more. As always, these videos are sponsored by Ultimate Guard, sponsor of Team CFB, and of course, TCG Player, which is your home for everything you need on for any card game online. Check out tcgplayer.com for pretty much anything you're looking for. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.